Hello everyone and welcome to this brand new video on our YouTube channel. Today we are standing in an abandoned home somewhere in Belgium. Time has stood still here for some 40 years. The man who lived here, Mr. Joseph, was an employee of Sabina. In 2001, Sabina's bankruptcy was declared by the Commercial Court of Brussels. But the man was lucky because he was already retired at that time. This house was a part of Mr. Joseph's life. Because he worked for Sabina, he visited many countries himself, and you can see that in a number of aspects in this house. Let's explore this house together. So the first room where we are in is, I think it was like a dining room, but they removed the table. As you can see, we see some details already. It's like we are walking into a time capsule. This old stove, you don't see them often nowadays. Actually, nowadays you don't see these things. So what do we have here? Some religion things. Also, this is also something from old houses that they split up. The dining room and the living room, I think. We also see this calendar on the wall from the year 1976. Oh, I'm not sure if it's and it's pictures from Belgium states, places in Belgium. I'm not sure if this is really the date that this became abandoned or if it's put into scene. But if we look to the old furniture, yeah, it can be possible for sure. Also, we just noticed that the people who have lived here really liked to travel. They have souvenirs from countries all over the world. You see, this one might be from Spain. Here we see another one from Italy, from Venezia, I think. Mm-hmm. Then maybe this camel can be Egypt, I think. So, and this dog represents maybe cold countries. You see, he is carrying something. There is alcohol in it, you know. And so if you are lost in the snow, this dog, he bring you the alcohol so that you come back to your positives. It's crazy, actually, if you think about it. So this folder might be represents Russland. It's or Soviet times or something. It's, yeah, I think it's Russian. Crazy, they went to many different countries, I think. The people who have lived here probably must have traveled to many different countries. We really got that feeling at this spot. They were also religious people. We found pictures from Jesus and the Last Supper, some old group photos taken in a church, and a lot of crosses and saints. And from here we can walk to the hallway, where we can go upstairs. And I think there is a basement as well. So the basement is here, I think. First we go upstairs. The shoes are still here, nice into place. But it's also stacked, I think. So up here they had three bedrooms. They have one master bedroom and two smaller bedrooms. There is also a lot of decay in these bedrooms. Some nice details, ripped curtains, wallpaper coming from the wall. It's soap. It's soap, I think. Yes, there is soap inside. Oh yeah, you see? Soap. Those people really wanted to have it clean, I think. We have seen a lot of soap, we have seen a lot of dash for washing your clothes. Here we see something else with the date on it. 1965. So this is actually a stroke from the people who lived here for their retired income. This basically means that this house was really abandoned before the 2000s, because if they had pension income in the year 1965, yeah, then unbelievable that it's still in this shape. It must be abandoned for at least 20 years, maybe 25. It was like we had gone back in time 40 years. All the old stuff lying right in front of our eyes, covered in dust. No one had been here for years. Funny that such places keep popping up. Here we are walking into the master bedroom. This is the biggest bedroom, I think. The mirror is, yeah, it had its best time. An old chair to, yeah, it's like toilet next to the bed for probably for old people. If they needed to go to the toilet at night, they just can do it there, and in the morning they emptied it, you know. I can hardly believe that this is abandoned for more than 20 years. I've been into buildings that are abandoned for 5 years and look more worse than this one. Here we have another bedroom where Omi is doing some things, I don't know. Probably for making a picture from this bed with all the dash. Famous picture. So we have seen many pictures from this room with all the dash, with all the soap, with everything, with this bed. So, and this is something that you only see in old houses, a string where you can pull on, a string to pull for the light. If you pull on the string, the light goes on. We can't try it because one, there is no lamp, and second, I don't know if there is still power. So after we have seen all the bathrooms, there is one more floor left, I think the attic, or maybe the second floor and then the attic. Let's see. Old radio in the hallway. So I wonder that we can see upstairs. Let's go. So this is an attic, there is some parcel and the neighbors are home, so we need to be careful. Yes, this is the attic. It's a strange atmosphere, but in back the days people hang their laundry on the attic instead of in the garden. Nowadays people put their laundry in the garden or maybe in the tumble dryer, but back the days they did it on the attic. More of the sunlight soap. You don't see this now anymore. It's really, really old soap. Is there actually a date on this thing? I don't think so. It's soap, you know. 200 francs zullen betaald worden aan degene die kan wijzen dat deze zeep vervaardigd is door. Oh, it says they will pay you 200 Belgian franc for those we can prove if this soap was made by Savonier. What? This is really. So they will pay you if you had legit soap.
What?
Zegt de rare staat er echt op.
Oh, see, more Persil. They really had a lot of these things. And it's still inside, eh? It's they didn't... Oh, zeepoeder. It's so powder. How can I have so many of them? And we also see this small gate. Let's have a look. It's not enough. It's maybe... No, it's nothing, but... Dirt. We still need to explore the basement. We have some Andalus. And where is the date? Oh, no date.
So.
Yeah, 2014. Oh, there is a table here. Oh, there is a wall living here. No, I don't know. But there is a small table here. Ah, those pots. Last time I've seen this, it was in Paternoster, farm Paternoster, on strong water.
Dat is typisch oude mensen. Mijn grootouders doen dat ook.
Echt, hè?
Ja.
Dat blijft er langer goed. Oh ja, yeah, and I found someone who likes to go into basements. Juice.
Zo'n hele water, verrek.
Water.
Loerde.
Ah, loerdewater. Holy water.
Tegen zware verkoudheid, hardnekkige hoest en bronchitis.
So, people back the day they drink holy water to make their health better. Oh, this is interesting. Ook bronchit en zo.
Ze geloofden dat het daar niet
komt. Ja. But because it's on strong water, it's still looking good.
Ik vraag me af hoe lang jij daarvan kan eten dan.
Lang denk ik, maar ik ga er toch niet meer van eten.
Ja,
so those people probably survived the war. And in the war, yeah, there was not much to eat, so they put it in on strong water. No, I think it's not. Just old people do it. They did it back today. Nowadays, they don't do it anymore. Nowadays, we are too lazy. We go to the store to buy something new. So, this is for the heating, I think. Some more jars.
The atmosphere inside this basement was so crazy to see, but I didn't have a bad feeling at all down there. Those bottles were interesting to see. There was also some very old wine.
These bottles of wine, they are not opened yet. This is really, really old. So, and here we have the kitchen. There is an old cooker. But yeah, what else did you expect? We are in the kitchen. It's an oven, yes. And this, it's... Oh. Yeah, this is a really old washing machine. Whoa, really old. Whoa. You did the laundry in it from above? Really?
I'm used with this machine. So you put the wash into the machine, you close it. Then it's turning, like a normal washing machine. When it's finished.
Okay, that's pretty interesting.
So it's just like a normal washing machine, but you put the laundry from above.
Yeah, that's really ancient for me.
Yeah, it's from the 60s. It's just like the cars. the leather type, you can see.
Yeah, from the 60s.
From the 60s.
So here we have some nice details too. It's you do this in your eyes, when your eyes are hurting. So there is still a garage with a car inside, but we need to run quick because maybe the neighbors can see us. Ready to run?
We have to.
So, yes, this is the garage. So here we see the old cars that is still in the garage. It's I think it's a Renault. Let's see. But some explorers, they actually ruined it a bit. So unfortunately we cannot go inside, and we didn't see a car key either inside the house, so unfortunately. Also, back the days, they had their toilets outside. You see, this is an old toilet. Now I think about it, I didn't see a bathroom inside the house. So this is really, oh crap, this is really, really old. Yeah, because now I think about it, I didn't even see a bath inside the house. Not a shower.
Only.
That was everything for this week's video. I would like to thank you for watching. If you like abandoned places, then feel free to subscribe to this YouTube channel. I will upload every Sunday a brand new video.